Yesterday we have discussed about the layer of stomach, which is inside epithelium, after that lamina propria, as shown in the figure, then muscular mucosa, then submucosa, then muscularis propria, and outside is adventitia, right? This side, this is another view. Serosa, longitudinal muscles, circular muscles, submucosa, mucosa, mucosal muscles, mucosa, epithelium, lining, and lymphoid tissues, mucosal glands, submucosal glands. So you have seen that how this stomach is arranged in different layers. The wall is divided into four layers as follows. जैसे हमने बात की, जैसे ये पीछे इसमें नजर आ रहा है आपको. सबसे पहली जो अंदर की लेयर है, that we call it mucosa. ठीक है, तो हम इसको डिस्कस करते हैं. Mucosa, innermost layer of the digestive tract, has specialized epithelial cells. ये एक specialized epithelial cells है, और supported by an underlying connective tissue layer called the lamina propria. Here you can see the lamina propria also. Here is a lamina propria. You can see over here, second layer. Contains blood vessels, nerves, lymphoid tissues, and glands that support the mucosa. Depending on its function, the epithelium may be simple, a single layer, or a stratified multiple layer. So we study one by one each of the layer of the stomach. Right, so the wall is divided into four layers. First is the mucosa, and as I have mentioned you, the inner layer of the digestive tract has specialized epithelial cells supported by an underlying connective tissues called the lamina propria. The lamina propria contains blood vessels, nerve and lymphoid tissues. Three things are there, and certain glands are also that support the mucosa. Depending on its function, the epithelium may be simple, a single layer, or a stratified multiple layer. Single means one layer of epithelial cells, or if it is more than one layer, then we call it a stratified or multiple layer. Areas such as the mouth and esophagus are covered by a stratified squamous flat epithelium, so they can survive the wear and tear of passing food. Simple columnar, tall or glandular epithelium lines the stomach and intestine to add secretion and absorption. The inner layer is consistently shed and replaced, making it one of the most rapidly dividing area of the body. Means the inner layer, the epithelium, the mucosa, they shut down, means they remove each and every day, and comes the new cells on top. Beneath the lamina propria is the muscularis muscles mucosa. This comprises layer of the smooth muscles which can contract to change the shape of the lumen. This helps in the peristalsis of the intestine and movement of the stomach. Some mucosa surround the muscularis mucosa and consist of the fat, fibrous connective tissue, and large vessels and nerves. If you take it like this, fat, right? Then we fibrous connective tissue. Large vascular nerves. Right? So this is the arrangement. Some people are fat, fibrous tissue, and large. In the same way, if we'll go for the mucosa, if we take this also like that, the lamina propria contains kya hota hai isme? Number one is blood vessels, number two is nerve, number three is lymphoid tissues. And number five is glands that support the mucosal lining. So this is the arrangement of the mucosa. Mucosa ka ye arrangement hota hai. What is easy to understand, at its submucosa, at its outer margin, there is a specialized nerve plexus called the submucosal plexus or a Meissner's plexus. At its outer margin, iske submucosa ke outer margin, there is a specialized nerve plexus, means a bunch of nerve, called the submucosal plexus or Meissner's plexus. This supplies the mucosa and submucosa. Muscularis externa, this smooth muscles layer has inner circular and outer longitudinal layer of muscles fibers separated by the myenteric plexus or Auerbach plexus. So at the muscularis externa, what is there? The smooth muscle layer has inner circulation, an outer longitudinal layer of the mucosal fibers separated by the mesenteric plexus or the Auerbach plexus. Neural innervation means nerve innervation control the contraction of these muscles and hence the mechanical breakdown and peristalsis of the food within the lumen. Serosa or mesentery, the outer layer of the GI is formed by fat and another layer of the epithelium called the mesothelium. Now we talk about the individual component of the gastrointestinal tract, in which we will see a different parts of the GI tract. So first we go through individual component of the gastrointestinal, right from the mouth up to the anus. First we talk about the mouth, oral cavity. We call it oral cavity. Oral means mouth. Oral cavity or mouth is responsible for the intake of food. It is lined by the stratified squamous oral mucosa with keratin covered those areas subject to significant abrasion such as the tongue, hard palate and roof of mouth. So mastication means chewing or crushing. Mastication means crushing. Mastication refers to the mechanical breakdown of food by chewing and chopping. We call it chewing and chopping action of the teeth. The tongue is a strong muscular organ, manipulate the food bolus to come in contact with the teeth. It is also sensing organ of the mouth for touch, temperature, taste using its specialized sensor known as the papillae. So test buds are there, we call it papillae. In salivation, refer to the mixing of the oral cavity content with salivary gland secretion. The mucin or glycoprotein in saliva act as a lubricant. The oral cavity also play a limited role in the digestion of the carbohydrate. Means carbohydrate is the digestion of carbohydrate started from the mouth through saliva. Benzyme serum amylase, a component of the saliva, start the process of digestion of complex carbohydrate. The final function of the oral cavity is absorption of small molecules such as the glucose, water across the mucosa. From the mouth, food passes through the pharynx and esophagus via the action of swallowing. Here is the shape of mouth, you can see. You can see the gums. And more large if you make it. You can see the hard palate. You can see the soft palate inside of the mouth. Buccal mucosa, you can see the buccal mucosa. Anterior tonsillar pillars, tongue, gingiva above the teeth, skin, vermilion junction. Lips, retromolar tragon, circumvelli papillae, floor of the mouth, and alveolar ridges. So this is the shape of the mouth you can see. Now we come on one by one. What is the salivary gland itself? Three pair of the salivary glands communicate with the oral cavity. There are three type of glands which are known as the salivary glands and which start secreting into the mouth. Each is a complex gland with a numerous acini lines by the secretory epithelium. The acini secretes their content into the specialized duct. Each gland is divided into smaller segments called the lobes. Salivation occurs in response to the taste, smell, or even appearance of the food. This occurs due to nerve signals that tell the salivary glands to secrete saliva to prepare and moisten the mouth. Each pair of the salivary glands secretes saliva with a slightly different composition. So we just discuss about the salivary glands, right? Which is located here, you can see on the face, under the cheek, and under the mandible. Now we come to parotid gland. The parotid glands are the large irregular shaped glands located under the skin on the side of the face. They secrete 25% of the saliva. They are situated below the zygomatic arch, cheekbone, and cover part of the mandible, lower jaw bone. An enlarged parotid gland can be easier felt with one clench their teeth. The parotid produce a watery secretion which is also rich in protein. Immunoglobulins are secreted, help to fight microorganism, and amylase proteins start to break down complex carbohydrate. Then there is another gland which is known as submandibular gland. The submandibular gland secretes 70% of the saliva in the mouth. They are found in the floor of the mouth in a groove along the inner surface of the mandible. These glands produce a more viscous, thick secretion rich in mucin and with a smaller amount of protein. Mucin is glycoprotein that acts as a lubricant. Then there are glands under the tongue which is known as sublingual glands. Sublinguals are the smaller salivary glands covered by a thin layer of the tissue at the floor of the mouth. They produce approximately 5% of the saliva and their secretions are very thick due to the large concentration of mucin. The main function are to provide buffer and lubrication. Here you can see different glands located in your mouth under the skin. Parotid gland, then under the tongue is sublingual gland, and under the mandible, submandibular gland. Sub means lower. Oesophagus. Oesophagus is a muscular tube of approximately 25 cm in length and 22 cm in diameter. It extends from the pharynx to the stomach after passing through an opening in the diaphragm. Diaphragm is a muscular layer which separates the thoracic cage and abdominal cage. The wall of the oesophagus is made up of inner circular and outer longitudinal layer of muscles that are supplied by the oesophageal nerve plexus. This nerve plexus surrounds the lower portion of the oesophagus. The oesophagus functions primarily as a transport media between the compartment. Anatomical position of oesophagus is origin in the neck at the level of the 6th cervical vertebra. It is continuous with the laryngeal part of the pharynx. It descends down into the superior mediastinum in thorax. Here it is situated between the trachea and the vertebral bodies T1 to T4, thoracic 1 to thoracic 4. It then enters the abdomen by piercing the muscular right grooves of the diaphragm through the oesophageal hiatus, simply the hole in the diaphragm at the T10 level. The pharyngeal ligaments connect the esophagus to the border of the esophageal hiatus, means the hole in the diaphragm. Esophagus is bound with a ligament, so it cannot move here and there. This permits independent movement of the esophagus and diaphragm during respiration and swallowing. Abdominal part of the esophagus is approximately 2 cm long. It terminates by joining the cardiac orifice of the stomach at level of T11. Means this esophagus will join to stomach, and we call it cardiac orifice, muscular layer. The esophagus consists of internal circular and external longitudinal layer of the muscles. Furthermore, the external longitudinal layer is composed of different muscles type in each third of the esophagus. Superior third, voluntary striated muscles. Middle third, voluntary striated smooth muscles. Inferior third, smooth muscles. Voluntary means with your intention, it will move. If you want to push the food down towards the stomach through your esophagus, you can do it because this is voluntary. This is on your will. Food is transported through the esophagus by peristalsis, means movement, a rhythmic contraction of the muscles which propagate down the esophagus. Hardening of these muscular layers can interfere with peristalsis and causes dysphagia, difficulty in swallowing. This hello.
Hello.
Food is transported through the esophagus by peristalsis, means movement, rhythmic movement, contraction of the muscle, following in gradual. When we take a food and we make a bolus, it won't fall just like a ball in the stomach, but it will go slowly and gradually with the contraction, relaxation of the esophagus. Sometimes there is a difficulty in swallowing, we call it dysphagia because of the hardening of the muscle of esophagus. Here you can see the figure. Esophagus is there, diaphragm is there, which is separating thoracic cage and abdominal cage. Half of the stomach is, means some of the portion of the fundus is near the diaphragm, another is under the diaphragm. Here is trachea in front of the esophagus. Upper esophageal sphincter is there, UE as we call it, throat, stomach. Lower esophageal sphincter is, we call it cardiac orifice or. Then we talk some accessory organs which help to the stomach. So we have liver. Liver is a large reddish brown organ situated in the right upper quadrant of the abdomen. It is surrounded by strong capsules and divided into four lobes, namely the left, right, left, caudate and caudate lobes. बहुत देर में आ रहे हैं आप लोग, क्या बात है, मैंने आपको मैसेज भेज दिया, अब आप ज्वाइन कर रहे हैं आप लोग, हैं? फिर क्लास खत्म होने वाली है तब आप लोग आ रहे हैं। आपको मैसेज भेज के जमाना हो गया मुझे, तब मैंने आपको मैसेज हैं नहीं कब मैसेज भेजा और कब आप लोग आ रहे हैं जरा सोचे। ये यहाँ पे नजर आ रहा है मुझे आपकी एंट्री कब हो रही है, देखिए मैं अभी बताता हूँ आपको। ये टाइम है आने का, फाइनल ईयर में आ गए आप लोग, कितना मैंने खत्म कर दिया है। चलें लीवर देखें, लीवर इज अ पार्ट ऑफ द डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम, एसेसरी पार्ट कहलाता है ये। द लीवर इज अ लार्ज रेडिश ब्राउन ऑर्गन सिचुएटेड इन द राइट अपर क्वाड्रेंट ऑफ द एब्डोमेन। एब्डोमेन को हम चार क्वाड्रेंट में, छह क्वाड्रेंट में हम डिवाइड करते हैं। तो अपर राइट साइड पे होता है लीवर, लेफ्ट पे स्प्लीन होती है। इट इज सराउंडेड बाय अ स्ट्रॉन्ग कैप्सूल एंड डिवाइडेड इनटू फोर लोब्स, नेमली द राइट लोब, लेफ्ट लोब, क्वाड्रेंट लोब एंड क्वाड्रेंट। और क्या, आपका टाइम सुबह का होता है थर्सडे को, आपको मालूम नहीं है, आपको ये मालूम नहीं है बेटा। आपकी सुबह हो गई क्लास 9:10 पे, अभी आप सोते रहिए
जी। तो
अब जागो
सर, सर वो हमने ले ली थी सर। यहाँ पे लिवर वाला क्यों पढ़ा रहे हैं फिर, हमें क्यों नहीं किसी ने सेंड किया?
नहीं नहीं मैंने आपको तो नहीं सेंड किया, मैंने किसको सेंड किया है? इंजा को
सर, शफा किया है आपने, मुझे ही सेंड किया था ज्वाइन नाउ, और आपकी कॉल भी थी।
अच्छा मैं देखता हूँ एक मिनट।
आपने गलत जगह पे सेंड कर दिया, यहाँ पर आपको नहीं करना था।
आपकी क्लास नहीं बताई, आपकी क्लास नहीं, आपकी क्लास हो गई सुबह।
वही तो गई थी, क्लास हो गई, लिवर क्यों पढ़ रहे हम बैठ के?
नहीं नहीं आपका नहीं है ये फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर वालों की क्लास है, जो मैं रात को
सेकंड वो बेचारे कर रहे होंगे।
आपकी तो फर्स्ट क्लास है, गलती से भेज दिया, छोड़ दीजिए उसको
जी।
Liver is a large reddish brown organ situated in the right upper quadrant of the abdomen. It is surrounded by the strong capsules and divided into four lobes, namely the left lobe, right lobe, quadrant lobe, or quadrate lobes. The liver has several important functions. It acts as a mechanical filter by filtering blood that travels from the intestinal system. It detoxifies several metabolites, including the breakdown of bilirubin and estrogen. In addition, the liver has a synthetic function producing albumin and blood clotting factors. However, in its main role in the digestion are in the production of bile and metabolism of the nutrients. All nutrients absorbed by the intestine pass through the liver and are processed before traveling to the rest of the body. The bile produced by cell of the liver enters the intestine at the duodenum. Here, bile salts break down lipids into smaller particles, so there is a greater surface area for the digestive enzyme to act. Here is the shape of the liver. Right lobe is there. You can see there is a quadrate ligament with joint attached the ligament liver to the keep it on that position through the ligament. Ligament teres for coronary ligament. There is a left lobe and then calciform ligament. There are three types of ligaments are there which attach liver at a proper position in the stomach, in the abdomen, sorry, not the stomach. Gallbladder. The gallbladder is a hollow, pear-shaped organ that sits in a depressed on the posterior surface of the liver. गॉल ब्लैडर. सो वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट द गॉल ब्लैडर. वी आर डिस्कसिंग हाउ दिस इज, वेयर दिस इज सिचुएटेड, हाउ डज इट वर्क, राइट? एंड the gallbladder is a hollow pear shaped organ that sits in the depression on the posterior surface of the liver side, right lobe. You can see here this is the gallbladder. It is positioned over here. You can see it empties via the cystic duct into the biliary duct system. The main function of the gallbladder is storage and concentration of the bile. Bile is a thick fluid that contains enzyme to help dissolve fat in the intestine. Bile is produced by the liver but stored in the gallbladder until it's needed. Bile is released from the gallbladder by contraction of its muscular wall in response to the hormone signal from the duodenum in the presence of food. Here you can see liver, gallbladder, pancreas in bile passage. It's an all anatomical position. You can see how the pancreas is placed, which head is joined with the duodenum, then open through the pancreatic duct and give their secretion into the duodenum, amylase and lipase. It has got a tail and a head and a body, pancreas. Liver has got two lobes. Then it has got three ligaments. At the back of the liver, there is a gallbladder. It gets the bile from the liver and is stored in gallbladder. And whenever it is required for the digestion, it will contract the gallbladder and send this bile to the liver. But if there is a removal of the bile duct, we call it cholecystectomy. Removal of the gallbladder is cholecystectomy, CH. And then you can see the duct is coming from the liver into the gallbladder. If you remove the gallbladder, it ties the neck of that tube, then the bile will come direct from the liver into the duodenum. So this is all about the digestive system, what we have learned today, anatomical discussion about the, we have started from here, chapter 29, but not 29, before that we have learned pancreas and all this. Chapter 28, 29. Now we discuss about anatomical structure. The pre-oesophagian anatomical structure. The phrenoesophageal ligament connects the oesophagus to the border of the oesophageal hiatus. This permit independent movement of the esophagus and diaphragm during the respiration in solid. Sorry, this we have already finished. Now we go through urinary system. Urinary system consists of kidney, the main organ, which forms the urine and excreted out from the body. You just keep in mind this figure and then I will discuss about the theory. Function of the urinary system. The urinary system removes certain salts and nitrogenous waste. Means waste and salts are removed from the body, which is harmful for the body, through the urinary system. Also help maintain the normal concentration of the water and electrolyte within the body fluid. Means they maintain the concentration of water. Maintain the concentration of water as well as salts in the body. Regulate the pH and volume of the body fluids. Help control red blood cells production and blood pressure. This is the most important function of the urinary system. Anatomy of the major organ function and the location. A pair of the kidney which removes substances from the blood form urine and help regulate certain metabolite process located high on the posterior wall of the abdominal cavity. There is a name given on over here. Just go through it and read it and learn it. Maybe I will give this figure and tell you about for labeling this figure. Right? So, anatomy of the major organ functions, organs and functions and location. A pair of tubular ureter. Where is ureter? Here is the ureter, which is coming from the kidney and entering into the urinary bladder. A pair of the tubular ureter, which transport urine from the kidney to the bladder. A sac-like urinary bladder which stores urine located in the pelvis, in lower side of our body near the legs. Tubular urethra which convey urine from the bladder to the out of the body. Means this urethra is situated in male in penis and in female near the vagina. And it will throw the urine out of the body. Pathway of the blood within the kidney. You can see here the blood flow through the renal kidney, interlobular arteries, arcuate arteries, interlobular arteries, afferent arterioles, glomerulus, efferent arterioles and peritubular capillaries. The one unit, a single unit, nephron, functional unit of the kidney that produces urine in the process of removing waste and excess substances from the blood, consists of renal corpuscles and renal tubules. Renal corpuscles, filtration unit of the vertebral nephron, functional unit of the kidney. Renal tubules, the part of the nephron that leads away from the glomerulus, causes the reabsorption and secretion. The difference between the two is the capsules is used for the filtration with the tubules is used for reabsorption and secretion waste away. Here is a figure of nephron in the kidney. They have taken one nephron. The nephron is like this. First, we have a red color glomerulus, which is a bunch of the vessels, and under a capsule, which is known as Bowman capsule. Then we have the proximal convoluted tubule near the Bowman capsule. Then we have a cortex of the kidney, upper part, and the inner part in medulla. We call it turning this loop of handle. And then we have the distal convoluted tubule, which join the ureter. And this ureter will join the urethra. And then put that ureter blood into the urine into the urinary blood. So here again, urine formation in the nephron. Glomerular filtration, blood flow from this create it will filter the blood renal corpuscle, tubular reabsorption, the electrolytes are reabsorbed, tubular secretion, which does not need to be secreted out, and then water conservation, it will save the water, bring it back to the body. So today we have discussed about some of the things. Here we are going to revise old material. We discuss about the basic structure today. Gastrointestinal tract is a muscular tube lined by a specialized lined by the specialized cell called epithelium, in which we have discussed about the different layer of the stomach: epithelium, lamina propria, muscularis mucosa, submucosa, muscularis propria, and adventitia. I have shown you certain anatomical figures in which clearly you can identify those layers which we have discussed verbally, like serosa, where it is located. Longitudinal muscles, circular muscles, submucosa, mucosa muscles, mucosa, epithelial linings inside, lymphoid tissues, mucosal glands which secrete the mucosa, submucosal glands. Here I have given you the description what the mucosa contains. Mucosa contains the lamina propria, contains the blood vessels, nerves, lymphoid tissues, glands and support the mucosa. We have talked about the submucosa also. The submucosa surround the muscularized mucosa and consist of the mucosa consists of fat, fibrous connective tissue, larger vessels and nerves. Then muscularis externa, This smooth muscular layers has inner circular and outer longitudinal layer of the muscular fibers separated by the mesenteric plexus or Ordoff complex. Serosa mesentery, the outer layer of the GI is formed by fat and another layer of the epithelium is called the mesothelium. Then we have discussed about the oral cavity, mouth, which has got a different function. Responsibility of taking food in, and the layer of the mouth is made up of a squamous stratified epithelium with keratin covering. Mastication refers to the mechanical breakdown of the food by chewing and chopping action of the teeth. Then the function of the tongue, muscular muscles manipulation the food. Muscles also have the buds, sensory buds, mouth for touch, temperature and taste. Then we have seen the saliva is produced by certain glands, and there are different type of glands. I've shown you the inside the mouth salivary glands. There are three types of salivary glands. One is a parotid gland, one is a sublingual gland, and one is a submandibular gland. Where is the clear appearance of the parotid gland, where it is located, and the sublingual gland under the tongue, and submandibular gland under the mandible. Then we have talked about the tube which takes food from the mouth to the stomach is known as esophagus. It has got a peristalsis. Slowly, gradually, it drops the food into the stomach. We have shown the anatomical position of the esophagus. Esophagus is bind with the ligaments. Esophagus has two types of layers. One is internal and one is external longitudinal layer. Then we have talked about the liver. Liver is an organ which produces the bile, and this bile is stored in the gallbladder, and gallbladder will throw this. When the food comes to the duodenum, it will give from the gallbladder, contact is a muscular, and it will give bile to the duodenum for the digestion of fat. Liver has got two lobes, left and right lobe, and have got three ligaments, coronary ligaments, calciform ligament, and ligament teres. At the back of the liver is the gallbladder, which stores the bile, which comes from the liver. And if we remove the bile, we call it cholecystectomy, and the bile will come directly from the liver to the duodenum without storing in the gallbladder, because that has been removed by surgery. Then we have little discussed about the urinary system, and we will go in detail in urinary system. I have to provide some more information about the urinary system. So we discuss in next class about the urinary system, which is very important system in the body, which help to eliminate the waste and the salts which are excess in our body, and retain those salts and other elements in the body for the different function of the body, because salts are very important in the body for the contraction of muscles as well as generation of electrical impulses from the neuron. We need sodium, chlorine and potassium. We need calcium for the contraction of muscles. So electrolytes are very important for the body and this kidney will maintain. So in next class, we will go in detail on this topic. You can see here the structure of the urinary system. At the top of the kidney is a gland known as adrenal gland, which produces adrenaline. Then we got the renal vein, the renal arteries. Renal vein collect the blood from the kidney, which is deoxygenated blood, and put it into the abdominal vena cava. which return blood to the right heart from the right atrium to the right ventricle and from right ventricle to the lungs for the purification. In the same way, the oxygenated blood is supplied to the kidney through the abdominal aorta, through the renal artery. The kidney itself consists of nephrons, number of nephrons, million of nephrons. This is a fundamental unit of the kidney, nephron. And this nephron function is to filter the blood of the body. 20% of the cardiac output, which is a 70 ml per stroke volume, is about 20% is 14 ml out of 70, 14 ml is filtered from the kidney every minute. Means the kidney output is about 125 ml blood is purified in the kidney per minute. After the purification, the kidney throws this waste urine into the ureter, and from the ureter, the urine comes into the urinary bladder. And then the urinary bladder is filled with the urine and stretch the wall of the urinary bladder. It will give a reflexive. And the sphincter of the urinary bladder to the urethra will open, and this urine will come to the urethra, and from urethra it will expel out of the body. The urethra size of male is about 17 centimeters, and female size is about 2.5 centimeters. This is a very alarming situation because the lower organs, male organ and female organ, is very near to the external environment. If the female has got 2.5 centimeters urethra, it means ascending infection is very common in female. So how to protect it? The nature has provided bacteria, which is a non-pathogenic bacteria in the vagina, and that produce acidic pH. And that acidic pH will kill the bacteria. But in female, in male, there is the urethra is about 17 centimeter long, and that naturally protected. So this is this anatomical adjustment of our organs are by the nature and providing protection to the human beings. If this won't happen, then there is a recurrent infection of the UTI, urinary tract infection, we call it UTI.